So you played with Tom Brady for what, 3 years? 3 years?
I played with Tom for 5 years.
5 years.
5 years, and I taught him everything he knows. Yeah, I was about 5 years ahead of him. I got drafted in 95, and then Tom was drafted in 2000.
Okay, so 5 years with Tom, and you won three yep. Super Bowls with Tom. When you watch Tom Brady now at age 40, now maybe there's a little bit of a decline, I mean, physically, because it's just natural, but the way he played in that AFC Championship game, man, he just made some unbelievable throws. When you watch him at age 40, what goes through your mind?
I'm amazed at his staying power. I mean, you know what? I'm so amazed that, like, the guy's not satisfied. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, I think the three of us would be like, I'm good. You know, I got all my money. I've got an established brand. I can pretty much do whatever I want. I cemented my legacy. I mean, if there's any more, and this is one of the topics I can't stand on sports times, is who's the best? Who's the best? We all know Tom Brady. To ever live. I mean, there's no dispute after what happened in last year's Super Bowl. And so, yeah, he still wants more. It's amazing to me. Now, guys, why can his game sustain as long as it is? Because Tom plays with his mind. That's his superhero kind of power right there, is his mind. He studies the opponent. A lot of the genius about Tom is all the stuff you don't see. He studies opponents. He prepares for opponents like nobody I've ever seen or even heard of. So he goes into these games. Like, here's the thing. Like, he knows where he wants to go with the football before the snap of the play. Do you know what a huge advantage that is for you? It's huge. And so he thinks his way through a football game. It's not like, you know, people used to ask me all the time, well, when was the first time you knew Tom was going to be Tom? I'm like, honestly, the first time I ever even really thought about Tom Brady was when my ex-wife at the time was like, have you seen Tommy Brady? He's so cute. I'm like, who? Like, he was a four-string quarterback, man. He was buried in a depth chart. Nothing about him really jumped out at you, his characteristics. But it was when you started seeing him run a two-minute drill, when you saw him making just decisions on the field that were like, oh, man, that was a smart play right there. And then you kind of start seeing the genius. He's just so smart, guys. He's as smart as he's ever been, right? I mean, look, after all these years of experience, I mean, there's nothing he hasn't seen. So he keeps himself in great shape. And if you protect him, if you keep him upright, a lot of the problems with the Patriots are when they have offensive line breakdowns. Block Tom Brady and keep him upright and safe. And he can do this for a long time, you guys. I really believe that.
You didn't notice any sort of diminished arm strength stuff this year? I felt like for the first time I saw some of that.
You might see it, but then you see, like you said, then you see games like he had, you know, last week. And look, the last five games of the season, I think he had an interception in each one of those games. He hadn't done that since 2002. So, yes, you could point to evidence. You could say, okay, well, right here, that's an example of that. You know, there were some throws that you would say, okay, huh? You know, maybe he's showing his age a little bit. But then he does what he does, you know, in the playoffs. And you're just like, okay, maybe I was wrong. And here's the thing, guys. And I swear, we're never in our lifetimes and in our kids' lifetimes, and hell, even in maybe our grandkids' lifetimes, are we ever going to see what we're seeing in New England. What are the odds that you get the greatest coach of all time, which I truly believe Belichick is? Well, I played for Bill Parcells, and I played for Pete Carroll, ironically enough. I've had those three coaches as my head coaches, which is pretty remarkable. They're all going to be Hall of Famers, I think. You know, at least one is, and two, one I know is a shoe in. I think Pete Carroll will get in there. And Belichick's just smarter than any coach I've ever been around. And then you pair him up with the greatest quarterback of all time, and their sensibilities are a little wide as far as what they want to achieve in their careers. Like, they both want people to see them as the best to ever do what they do. They're football historians. Their place in history means a lot. And so we're never, ever going to see this ever in the history of football, this type of success. It's unprecedented. You know, Tom's offense has morphed into different iterations all throughout the years with different coordinators, and that as his abilities got better and better, his role expanded in the offense. So he's had different iterations of offense. Well, Peyton, it's the same one. It's that 11 personnel, 3-by-1, in the shotgun, that kind of thing. So, you know, it's that's the one thing I say, well, that makes it more impressive for me. You know, maybe I'm biased. I'm a former teammate of Tom's. But, you know, Peyton was always in the same offense. Tom was always evolving, was always adapting and morphing into different offenses. So I always tend to kind of give Tom more of the nod in that respect.